Good morning, my friend. I hope you are doing well wherever you are in the world. I'm here on the beautiful bank of the North Platte River in Nebraska. It is 14 September 2021. I'm Dr. Lee Warren, and I am really excited. We've got a coalescence of several things happening here today that are perfect for what it is. This is episode one of season three of my podcast. I can't believe it. We did about 73 or 74 episodes of the old You Start Today podcast. And then we did 100 episodes of season one and 100 episodes of season two of the Dr. Lee Warren podcast. So this is episode number one of season three, and we are rolling. And it happens to land on a Tuesday, so you know what that means. We've got Dennis Tata McDonald here, and it's Tuesdays with Tata. So we're starting out a new season on a Tuesday with Tata and a reader of my newsletter and a listener of the podcast, a woman named Teresa, wrote in and asked a question about baptism. And I thought it was a perfect thing to talk to Tata about on episode one of season three, because baptism is all about rebirth, about renewal, about starting over. And this is the start of a new season. So all of that's kind of landing at the same time. And I thought, well, what kind of music could I play to get people into the right headspace to start a new season? And I thought of two songs. One is my old friend Paul Balash has a song called Today is the Day. We're going to play that in a little bit, because today is always the day to start today. And at the end of the show, we'll play a song called Day One by Matthew West. And Matthew West's song Day One, it's coincidentally, I know it's a God thing, but the day that Lisa and I pulled out of our driveway to move from Alabama to Wyoming, it was a new start for us after closing our business and selling our house and starting over. After we lost a son and all that stuff that I've talked about before, we decided to move to Wyoming, and we turned on the radio, and the first song that played literally as we were driving out of our driveway was a song called Day One by Matthew West. So I'm going to bring that back to you today. Beautiful song about starting over. It's day one of the rest of my life, day one of the best of my life. It's just a great song. So we have all this stuff coalescing to start on today, episode one, season three. About starting over, about starting today, about new beginnings and new births. And it's just a perfect way to get after it. I'm always telling you, get after it. And the reason I say that is when it's time, when your heart knows it's time to make a change, when your heart knows, when God is calling you and your spirit is urging you to make a stand, take a new start, do something different, shake off the past, and head off into the new place that God's calling you to, you have to start today. And I can't think of a better way to do that than on the first episode of a new season of the podcast. We even have new theme music. We're going to try out Make a Joyful Noise by Tommy Walker as a possible new theme song for the podcast. So let me know how you feel about that. And we're going to get after it. We're going to have Tuesdays with Tata and talk about all kinds of fun stuff today. And as always, my friend, we're going to start today. Hey, I'm so glad to have you listening. I'm Dr. Lee Warren, and it's season three of the podcast. I'm here in Nebraska in the United States of America with my incredible wife, Lisa Warren, and my father-in-law, Tata, and the super pups, Harvey and Lewis. I'm a neurosurgeon and an author, and I'm here to help you harness neuroscience, the power of your brain, faith, the power of your spirit, and good old common sense to help you lead a healthier, better, happier life. Listen, friend, you can't change your life until you change your mind, and I'm here to help you learn the art of self-brain surgery to get it done. You can get the show notes and more on my website, WLeeWarrenMD.com, WLeeWarrenMD.com. And if you like the show, please subscribe so you never miss an episode, and tell your friends about it. If you tell your friends about it, tap those three dots on your app. How much farther can we take this positive message around the world? I'm Dr. Lee Warren, here to help you change your mind and change your life. Let's get after it. Okay, so before Tata gets here, I want to play this song by Paul Balash called Today is the Day. This is just a great worship song. It's a great idea about just grabbing hold of today. God has made this day. He wants you to rejoice and be glad in it. He wants you to start today and shake off the past and get after it for a new future. And since it's the first episode of a new season, what better way than to sing this song, Today is the Day. Let's get after it, Paul Balash.
Heart and mind on you, Jesus.
Okay, my friend, we're here at season 3, episode 1, and I am right next to my main man, the one and only Dennis Tata McDonald. Hey, Tata, how you doing?
Hi, good morning. I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm great. Can you believe it's season 3 already?
No, I cannot.
We've done 15 or 16 of these episodes together already.
That's amazing.
It is amazing, isn't it? So I asked you today if we could talk about baptism. I'm going to read you an email that we got from Teresa Sagwitz, and she said, "Hi, Dr. Warren and Tata. I was baptized like many others as an infant. I'm now feeling as an adult. A baptism by immersion would reinforce my faith in our dear Lord. I'm just struggling because I'm not certain the church I'm attending is where I belong. I've been praying on it. What are your personal experiences with baptism, if you would be willing to share?" That's from Teresa in Connecticut. What do you think about that, Tata?
Well, first of all, I think that being baptized as an infant, that now, as an adult, you should give thanks to your parents for setting you upon a pathway, thinking that God would bless you in that process. And if you were fortunate, you were appointed godparents who prayed for you, who guided you, and who kept you in the way.
Yeah.
And so, in my mind, that's a blessing, and I think you should count it as a blessing. But now, as was stated, that as an adult, well, first of all, what is baptism? Baptism is meeting our Lord and Savior. And if you've come to a conclusion that Jesus Christ is the Son of God and that you want him to be your Lord and Savior, then you want to meet him. You want to see him. You want to be like him. And then, so if you said yes to Jesus, then baptism by immersion would seem to be the logical step for you. Because what it does is it demonstrates a death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You died to yourself, you're buried, and then you rose again, a new person.
That's
and
right.
So that blessing that you experience is profound, and don't take that lightly, because being baptized as an infant is a blessing, and you should thank your family for that.
That's right. So it's a great question. You know, the idea, I think it's fun too that this is day one of a new season of the podcast. It's something brand new, and we're talking about baptism, which is a new beginning, right? So Paul talked about the idea that it's a death to the old, a burial of your sinful life, your old flesh, and a resurrection into a new life. And I was thinking about my conversation with Dane Ortland the other day, Dad, and I want to play you something Dane said and just get your take on it, okay?
Okay.
His grip of us is invincible. And if we are in Christ, Jesus would have to be brought down out of heaven and put back in the grave in order for Christ to lose his grip of us. That's the logic of the New Testament. That's what it is to be in Christ.
What do you think about that, Dad?
Well, that is a very, very deep subject, because being in Jesus Christ, I have no comprehension of that, how he does that and how the Holy Spirit works. But I know this, that I have a sense of peace that I cannot even explain today. I have no comprehension of that peace. I can't describe it. There are no words that I know, no descriptors that I'm aware of that would tell me or tell you or any of our listeners how it is to come to a peace with yourself.
Yeah.
And realize that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior. He is God's Son. He is our Savior and our Redeemer. And he's made a way for us. He came here to be like us so we could be like him.
Yeah.
And that to me is a stretch as I consider myself.
That's right. Well, you know, I played that Dane Ortland clip because there's a lot of people who argue about what baptism is and what it's for and what it means. And I think the big picture is, it's just, as Chris Hodges always says, God said, do it. So we don't have to think too much about it. We ought to just do it. So I would just encourage you, friend, if you've never been baptized as an adult, what this is an opportunity for you to publicly declare who your Savior is and that you're identifying with him. And you can go through this process of dying to yourself and being buried and letting him wash everything away, and you'll come up a new person. And Paul says that gives you a new chance to live a new life.
What my feeling about it is this, that it's a meeting. We meet Jesus Christ in that process.
Yeah.
Now, how that feels, it depends on the person. But for me, meeting Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior was profound and amazing to me to even consider. Because in my mind, I'm always thankful that God is even mindful of me, that he's even noticing me. He even sees my shadow. He remembers that we are but dust. And what a powerful picture that is, to know that God loves us and he cares about us and he just wants us home.
That's right. So I hope that answers your question, Teresa. We would encourage you to be baptized as an adult. I think it's crucial to help you have a new understanding and a new peace about your relationship with Christ. And it's just a great way to start today, right, Tata?
Amen. We start today.
That's right. Now, there's a song by Matthew West that I'm going to play now called Day One. I said earlier in the intro that when Lisa and I were moving from Alabama to Wyoming, it was a new start for us. And we turned on the radio in the driveway of our house on Covington Ridge in Auburn. And the first song that came on was this song by Matthew West, and it's called Day One. And he says, it's day one of the rest of my life, day one of the best of my life. I'm marching onto the beat of a brand new drum. Lord, here I come. It's day one. So just this great idea. So here we're going to play Matthew West's song, Day One.
I wish I had a short-term memory. Wish the only thing my eyes could see was the future burning bright right in front of me. But I can't stop looking back. Yeah, I wish I was a perfect picture of somebody who's never not good enough. But I try to measure up, but I mess it up. And I wish I wasn't like that. I wish I wasn't wishing anymore. Wish I could remember that nobody's keeping score. I'm tired of throwing pennies in a well. I gotta do something. Here goes nothing. Grace reminds me that my best days are not behind me. Wherever my yesterday may find me, well, I don't have to stay there now. See, my hourglass is upside down, and my Sunday soon is here and now. The clock is ticking, and I'm so sick and tired of missing out. I wish I wasn't wishing anymore. Wish I could remember that nobody's keeping score. I'm tired of throwing pennies in a well. I gotta do something. Here goes nothing.
That's a great song. What do you think, Tata?
We start today.
That's right.
And I'm looking out right now at the breaking of the dawn. And that, to me, is a brand new day. And if you think about it, waking up is like the resurrection.
Amen. Every day.
That's right. It's new. And our prayer should be, show me what you want me to know today, Lord.
That's right. And friend, God says, this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. And I want you to know something. If you've been washed in the waters of baptism, you're a new person. The old has gone and the new has come. You're in a new start of your life. And today, you've got new skin cells on your body, new brain cells in your head.
Right.
Every cell in your body is different. You're not the same person you were yesterday. So you don't have to be stuck with those labels and shames and traumas of the past. You can step into a real new day. And the most important thing about changing your mind and changing your life is that you have to start when, Tata?
You have to start today.
That's right. Hey, thanks for listening. The Dr. Lee Warren Podcast is listener-supported. Check out patron.podbean.com/Dr. Lee Warren. patron.podbean.com/Dr. Lee Warren. Patrons and partners get free books, transcripts, special patron-only episodes, and more. And partners like you allow us to stay ad-free and keep growing. Please subscribe to the show so you automatically get every episode. And don't forget the three links you need to know. wleewarrenmd.com/newsletter to get the weekly letter full of the best information for how you can change your mind and change your life. wleewarrenmd.com/voicemail to leave us a message. Keep it classy. not to beep you, but please leave me a message and we'll include some of those on the show. You can ask questions, leave comments, you can ask input for future episodes, anything you need, wle1mb.com/voicemail. And finally, the most important one, if you need prayer or you would like to join us in praying with and for people all over the world, please go to the prayer wall, wle1mb.com/prayer, wle1mb.com/prayer. The theme music for the show is Make a Joyful Noise by Tommy Walker, graciously provided for free by Tommy and the good people who are changing the world one song at a time over at Tommy Walker Ministries. Please get the music for free and consider supporting Tommy's great work at TommyWalkerMinistries.org, TommyWalkerMinistries.org. Don't forget the prayer wall. Don't forget the prayer wall, WLE1MD.com/prayer. Remember, friend, you can't change your life until you change your mind. You have to start today. I'm Dr. Lee Warren, excited for Season 3. I'll talk to you soon. God bless you, friend, and have a great day.